I like to tell you what doesn't work, because I think the nutraceutical industry, frankly, my opinion, is completely out of control. So this is Prevegen. Prevegen is now a highly marketed, over-the-counter supplement. It has a lot of TV ads. And let me show you what some of the information is that is actually true. According to the FTC and the New York Attorney General, the trial included 218 adults taking 10 milligrams of Prevegen versus placebo and failed to show a statistically significant improvement in the treatment group over the placebo on any of the 9 computerized tests. The complaint alleged that after the Madison Memory Study, that is the Prevegen study, failed to find a treatment effect for the sample as a whole, Quincy researchers broke down the data in more than 30 different ways. This is data interpretation by Cuisinart. Drop everything into the Cuisinart and let's see what we can find. That is absolutely not kosher in research. You don't do post hoc statistical analysis and cherry pick your population. Then the FDA sent them a warning letter last year saying you've got to change your language because you're making false therapeutic claims. There's another one. This is Neuriva. This is also marketed with television ads. They had a recent class action suit. So they had to change their labeling from clinically proven and science proved to clinically tested and science tested. It's very important to read the language at face value without making suppositions as to what it means. This is the subtlety of marketing, and the reason I convey this to you is not to convince you that this doesn't work, but so that you are empowered to inform your patients, not what your opinion is, but what the research shows. You want to take these products? What's the target symptoms? We'll do it for 2 or 3 months, and then let's call it a day, because it gets very expensive to take something that makes your pee expensive and does little else.